Hey YouTubers, welcome back. Ben with True Cable. And today we're going to talk about how to terminate and strip prepare a fiber optic cable. What I've got with me today is OM4 multimode cable here indoor, as well as an outdoor OM4 multimode cable. So we're going to prep indoor cable here today and show you how to prepare that and get it ready for either a splice or a connector. So stay tuned. So the tools that we're going to be using today for this job is, first off, safety glasses, very important. These are important because you could possibly get shards of glass that can fly up into your eyes. So safety glasses, very important. Next, we're going to make sure and have our cable cutter. So this has our 2 and 3 millimeter cutter for the jacket of the cabling, as well as stripping off 250 and 900 micron buffers, as well as our Kevlar cutters or our aramid strength member. So this will cut that back. We've got our cleaning pieces. So we've got our fiber optic cleaning solution, as well as some wipes here. And then we have our cleaver. And this is what's going to give our nice clean, flat cleave of our fiber optic cable itself. So those are the tools that we're going to use today in order to do this. Many times you might have a specific little hazardous waste bucket that would be right here in those shards of glass could be dropped into it, but this cleaver actually also has its own little built-in one on the cleaver itself, so those little shards can get dumped right into there. So we'll be using that for this demonstration. So today we're going to look at how you strip and prep your fiber optic cable and getting it ready for either a fusion splice or mechanical splice to a connector, or just a regular mechanical splice connection as well. Here we have this OM4 multimode cable by True Cable, and this is a UL listed cable, as well as this is an plenum rated cable. And so we're gonna look at how to strip back this fiber, get it prepped and ready for whichever type of connection is gonna be made. So the first off, what we're gonna need is we're gonna need to put our safety glasses on. So we got those on. And then we're gonna need these fiber strippers. And there's various different kinds of fiber strippers out there, but this one particularly has the ability to strip back the 3 millimeter jacket, so that'll be stripping the jacket off. Then we have a 900 micron for the buffer, and then down to a 250 micron to take that acrylite coating off. So that's processed there, and so we'll get started here, and we'll take off the jacket first. So with the jacket, is really going to depend on the connector or the splice that you're making. So that's going to be kind of dependent on how far back you're going to need to cut that back. But in this case, for demonstration purposes, we're going to cut it back about 6 to 8 inches. So we'll just go ahead and do that right now. And it's just a quick little score. And when you do that, it just simply really easily slides off. So the jacket then is slid off, and that can just be set aside and put away. What we have here is a 2-strand fiber. So we've got our 2 individual strands, the blue and the orange here, and then we have our aramid strength member, or oftentimes called Kevlar. So we can just kind of stick that back to the side. Sometimes it's cut off, other times it's used on the connector assembly part to strengthen that connection with the connector. So for now, we'll stick it aside. So we're gonna just show stripping of one of these strands. So we'll go ahead and start stripping this back using the 900 micron part of the stripper, and we'll take it back to about an inch. And it'll just kind of keep going here, kind of a tedious part of the job. Here we go. So there we go. We got about, about an inch and a half stripped off, and now we'll just kind of make sure we take that coating off, and that looks pretty good. So now that we have our fiber stripped into the length, the next step is to clean this fiber before we actually cleave it. So that's the next step. We have our cleaning solution right here, and we have our wipes. So we want to just take one of these wipes off here. We want to give it a little bit of cleaning solution on the wipe, and we just want to, in an upstroke motion, kind of clean it. And you know it's clean when you start to hear kind of a sound as you actually clean it. You can kind of feel it and hear like a little creaking sound. I don't know how else to describe it, but as you do that, you can hear it. and you know it's clean, so it's ready to cleave. Now, if you want to, at this point, you can cut off your aramid yarn to get that out of the way. So we could do that and just cut that off. And these are the Kevlar cutters used to do that. So we'll cut that off and we'll just set that aside. This is just a standard cleaver, nothing too special, but it's got the adjustments for the different fiber optic cleave lengths that you need. There's some additional adapters that can be added depending on the size of fiber that you're going to be cleaving. And here, actually, on this cleaver, it's pretty nice. It has its own little waste bin for the excess fiber that you're cleaving off. If we go ahead and open this up, we'll just drop down the fiber optic cable into the slot. We want to get it lined up there specifically and drop the little magnetic piece. And that's going to close the cleaver onto the fiber cable itself, and then we can cleave it, and then that's it. And then we pull it off, and now we have our little shard of cable that will go into the waste bin, and then we have our clean cleaved fiber optic cable. Now again, don't want to mess with it too much here. It'll be ready to either slide into the fiber optic connector or the splicing machine. And again, it's very important that you clean this fiber before you cleave it and not after, because once you've cleaved it and you try and clean it after, then you're going to introduce perhaps dirt and dust onto the fiber optic cable, and that could be a problem. So make sure you clean it before. So thank you so much for watching, and if you like this video, please comment down below, and as always, happy networking.
Thank you very much for watching the video. You may not be aware of it, but we also have extensive blogs at our Cable Academy, 200 plus and counting. And most of the videos that you actually see here on YouTube are in fact embedded in a blog, which is far more detailed in regards to photography and descriptions. So I strongly recommend you head over to our Cable Academy, truecable.com, and check it out.